Queer to Queer, we will most likely not be renewing next year. This is a very grim way to start the episode.
Sorry.
Anyway, today we're going to have a huge... Oh, there's Kiyana running.
Oh my god, wait. Maybe I can get her. Oh no, none of the cameras are set up properly.
Oh no.
Too bad. Well,
today we're going to have a mass awards show, like, you know, how usually do it at the end of every season, do a little award show for the season, but we're going to do it for our show this time. And yeah, I'm your host today, Assal. I go by they and she, and
oh, I'll get the
word. Kiana's locked up. No. Okay. We're here. And so this is going to be not like our regular shows. It's going to be chaotic, but we'll embrace it. Yeah. If you guys want to introduce yourselves too.
Okay. I might as well. Hello, everybody. My name is Lily. My pronouns are they, them. And I am happy and sad to also be there. This is like the end of an era. This is very Hunger Games, this music. I feel like I'm like ready to go into battle right now.
Okay. Or maybe I'll turn the low
No. I love it though. Okay, I love it.
It's intense.
Yeah, I'm sad but also happy. We've had a good run, but you know, going into our last year, I think we're all gonna be extremely busy. So unfortunately, this is the end of the road, but you know what? Reunion episode in 10 years, so.
When we graduate, there we go. We can do it.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm excited to get... These are always, like, a fun episode to do, I think. I always have a good time, so. Yeah.
This music's getting me pumped.
Madie,
yeah.
You want to introduce yourself?
I'm Madie. I'm the board op. She, her. And I didn't start talking on like the first seasons of Queer to Queer. I did not talk, but you know,
you've evolved.
Team, yeah, the team helped me evolve a little bit, and now I talk a little bit.
Yay.
So, woo!
We love you, Madie. And also, Maddie's not just a board op; is the reason why the show runs.
Yeah, Madie carries all of our socials, everything,
like,
all of the beautiful.
In check. She's like, guys. Episode topic.
She keeps us in check, and all the beautiful posts you see on our Instagram, all of our social medias, our YouTube, our Twitch, all created and run by the lovely Madie. So
yes.
Stop.
We wouldn't be here without her.
Oh, I couldn't do it without you guys and your lovely episode topics and all your knowledge. So. Love you guys.
You brought the Glee episodes. It was amazing.
Yes. The Glee episodes, I think, were like what? The first episodes you like.
Mm-hmm. Really contributed.
Really contributed to. And yeah. We love having your input on the show.
Stop.
You're great.
I love being here.
Aw, guys. What if we cry?
We're not going to cry.
What if we all just start like sobbing?
If you cry, I cry.
Yeah.
Don't cry.
Okay.
Oh my god, chaos. I didn't introduce myself.
Yeah. Oh, go ahead.
Oh. Yes. Hi. I'm Kiyana, she, her. And I'm trying to be very happy, so I'm not very sad.
Yeah.
You know, because final ep, if I let myself feel sad, then
I know.
I don't know. I was literally thinking about it on the bus over here. I'm like, I'm going to be looking back at, like, our YouTube videos, and it's going to be like, whoa, nostalgia.
So sad.
At least we have those, though. I feel like that's nice, that we can have those to look back on.
Yeah.
And for sure.
Reunion episode.
We had a lot of fun. We had a lot of laughs.
Yes.
We did. Had a lot of laughs, some tears, some controversies.
Some rage.
Serious discussions.
Yeah, we talked about some. Yeah, there were some dark ones I feel like we talked about, but you know, that's the reality of being queer in the world that is burning. Also, just a note that our opinions stated in this show are only of our own and not the university.
Yeah.
Toronto metropolitan.
Yeah, our opinion. Unless we're like explaining what a show is, then that's not really an opinion. Mm. It's like, this is
that's
the plot
fact.
Of a
that's
show.
That's a synopsis.
Yes.
I also just want to start off by saying that we are nominated.
Oh my gosh, yes!
Sorry.
That was so loud.
So we're going to Tahara's tomorrow night.
Yay!
No,
tonight. It's tonight.
It's tonight.
Tonight's Thursday. Oh, it feels like Wednesday.
Yeah, it does not feel like Thursday, but that's so exciting. I forgot I wanted to mention that. Yeah. That's awesome. Yes. We are so honored to be nominated amongst, I think, like 5 other shows.
Yeah.
Yes.
So that's awesome.
Yeah.
We did it.
We're announcing an award, we got nominated for on our awards episode. So that's very fitting.
It is indeed. So I would say vote for us, but you can't.
Yeah.
So just keep us in your prayers.
Manifest
a win for us, please.
Yes.
Me and Kiyana were like, we're gonna bring crystals in our purse.
No, literally.
That's the only way I can be social and relaxed.
Yeah. I'm gonna be doing some like voodoo.
Thank you.
I'm gonna put pictures of all of us in a circle. Have my incense, like, I'm gonna write it down like 30s whatever times in my notebook. Yeah, exactly.
Honestly, I'm just proud of us for being nominated.
Yeah.
Also, usually we just forget.
To apply like every year.
Because it's like it happens during when we're the most busy.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
And can I just say, like, we're just trying our best on this show. We are like, I don't think any of us are like audio people. Like,
No.
Definitely not.
We have just been having fun and trying our best. So to get nominated for it, like, it just made me so happy.
Yes.
Like, I love this show. So.
Me too. And I think we've all put a lot of work into the show. It's all very special to us. I know, like, for me, this has been, like, the highlight of, like, school, not gonna lie. Mm-hmm. I haven't really done anything that's, like, as enjoyable as this has been. And it's been so nice to see people actually, like, say that they enjoy the show or that they're listening. Yeah. Like, looking at our Twitch, like, I always check the Twitch because I'm like... But seeing how, like, how many views even our Twitch gets sometimes has been, like, really exciting. Because, like, for us in here, it's like, we don't actually know if anybody cares or is listening. So it's really nice
really
to
know
see that.
If someone's listening on the website.
Yeah.
But the Twitch, it's like, we can see it immediately.
Yeah, and it's really awesome. So... thank you, everybody who has listened and supported
us
over the years. Our little queer-to-queer family.
Oh gosh, it's been years, you're right.
Yeah, it has,
that feels
weird. I think it has.
Wow, so proud of us.
I know.
Should we go through some awards?
Yeah, I think so.
Great.
Let's do it.
Tradition.
I feel like for once I have some new opinions. I feel like I've been saying the same things for the past 2 seasons.
I may still say the same things.
Yeah,
that's okay.
Like
me too.
I've changed, but I'm the same person.
Madie, your favorite is Halsey.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's okay. Sorry, I didn't mean to call you out like that. Anyway, let's get into it. What do we want to do? Favorite artist first? Musical artist, maybe if you have a favorite song.
I was going to do favorite episode, but we can do that last, I guess.
Yeah, that's a special. Yeah. That's a special one. Okay, so what are your favorite queer artists? If you have a favorite queer song as well, throw that in there.
Okay, I'll obviously start. Halsey is obviously my favorite queer artist. Mm-hmm. But Lily introduced us...
Oh my god, you're going to say Lucy Dacus.
No, okay, not even Lucy Dacus, but Lily introduced us to the song Night Shift. And why was it my top song of, like,
I love
whatever
it.
Month it was?
That made me so happy to see that you liked it. I was like...
No, I loved it. And then I sent it to all my friends. I'm like, guys, listen to this song. Because why
it's
does
so
Lily
good.
Always put us on the best? Because even last season 2... we played a song called Avant Gardener.
Yes, and then Courtney Barnett.
I put that one in my playlist too, and I just love
I'm gonna send you more.
That.
I'm gonna send you more, Lucy Dacus.
Yeah.
Courtney Barnett, there's some more that you would like too.
Okay,
I know.
Okay.
I know.
Love it.
I literally, every time now, I'm like, okay, would Maddie like this song? Because I'm like, I can't send it to you unless you're gonna like love it, you know? So I'm like,
That's
it has
funny.
To be like perfect.
You're like, vet it out first. Like,
yeah.
Okay, this is Maddie approved.
Maddie approved.
It's pre-approved.
Yeah. That's awesome, though. Lucy Dacus is also one of my favorites, though. Courtney Barnett, too. Fantastic. I think I've usually said Adrian Lenker was my favorite artist, which is still true. But given the new Boy Genius record out, Oh my god, I'm gonna sneeze. Okay, I'll hold it in.
Bless you.
Oh yeah, there's like a sneeze. Given the new record, which is like phenomenal, you should listen to that.
Okay, done.
I think like two songs.
It's, oh my god, it's really good. But I would say I'm gonna shout out Boy Genius as my favorite queer artist right now. That's Lucy Dacus, Phoebe Bridgers, Julian Baker. All
three.
Adorable.
Shout out Boy Genius.
Shout out Boy Genius. Yeah, sorry, Adrian Lanker. I've talked about you enough on this show, so you can take a backseat for now. But yeah, it's really good. I recommend everybody listen to it. It has a good balance of sad queer and like happy queer, which is awesome. Yeah. So that's my favorite artist right now. My favorite song on it is probably Cool About It or Not Strong Enough. So those are a good one. Also, I saw something that was like, Boy Genius sounds like Christian rock. And now every time I can't unhear it. I watched a show where there was Christian rock. And for a second, I was like, oh my God, are they playing Boy Genius? And I was like, no way. So if you're into Christian rock, you might enjoy Boy Genius.
That's fine.
Anyway.
That's a weird parallel.
Yeah.
Didn't know what would happen ever.
It's true, though. It is. I'm sweating also. Yes. Can we just talk about how it's
this
35
room is
degrees?
So hot.
Yeah, we do this every week for you guys, and it makes us it's not good.
I have to literally like plan my outfits like the normal heat and then this room heat. I'm like, how can I not die in this 1 hour?
Yeah, I'm wearing jorts right now.
Oh, I love jorts.
I was going to show the camera, but you can't see. It's too bad.
Outfit of the day.
Outfit of the day.
It's giving.
That's our next show.
Yeah, no, one thing I won't miss is this room. Like, it's very cool.
Yeah.
Everything runs great. It's just so hot.
Yeah.
And the lights are so either so bright or so dim.
Yeah. It was kind of nice in the winter sometimes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
If you were, like, freezing. But no. But whatever. It's summer, so we shouldn't complain.
I can't believe we started out doing it through Discord.
Yeah, that's
like,
crazy.
Oh, that's true.
We barely saw each other ever.
No, literally.
It was all just like
now
through Discord
like,
for an hour.
Yeah.
We met for the first time, like, all together, like, last year, March.
Yeah.
That's true. Crazy. That's true.
That's wild.
COVID.
Oh, I forgot to change the thing. Sorry, guys. Slacking on the multicam. Always.
Why did I forget my favorite queer artist? Like, I literally just had two down and I don't remember them anymore.
Oh, no.
Whoopsie.
I'm trying to remember.
Oh,
I feel like you've talked
about
some.
Pater.
Oh, yes.
Pater. King Malice Fun. I feel like there's a lot of, like, TikTok queer artists that I love, but I don't really know their name. I listen to, like, one song.
Gracie Abrams.
Yeah.
Is she queer?
I know
actually,
that
I might have made that up.
But I don't know.
I don't know if she's queer, actually. There's another one. Oh, yeah. I don't know if she's queer either. They all give queer.
I know.
The music.
I always do that.
Queer.
I listen to songs. I'm like, queer music. And then I'm like, I have no idea who this person is.
And then it's like about a man. And I was like, oh.
It feels wrong.
I'm like, this feels like lesbianism. What's going on here? That's how I feel listening to Hozier. Anyway.
Oh, yeah.
Like,
he is a lesbian.
He is.
The lesbian community adopted him.
Yeah, I think so.
Many years ago. Many moons ago.
Yes.
Who's your favorite?
Every award, my queer artist is like some weird electro EDM person.
We love that.
But this time, I think y'all know her. Kim Petras.
Ooh, good answer.
She's good.
I'm really into the club 2000s pop. It really hits, and she's really creative with it.
She's awesome.
But
she's brilliant.
Yeah, for my queer song though, it's by a different artist, Girl in Red. We all know her.
We all know her.
And the song is "Stupid Bish," censored version, you know, for the live.
I don't know
if I've really
heard
good.
That one.
It's very, like, it's really angry good. Love.
Ooh.
I'm like, ooh.
You should listen to Courtney Barnett if you like angry queer music. There's some, like, stomping ones.
That sounds very familiar.
When you want to stomp down the street, you know?
I think I do know that artist.
Yeah.
Barnett.
We've played it on the show before.
Yeah.
That's probably why I know it. It's funny. Okay, next category.
Next category is
favorite book.
Favorite book. Ooh,
okay.
Do any of us read?
My my
this is your category.
Maybe the same as all the time. Let me see what I did for last season's. Okay. Evelyn Hugo, Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo.
Oh yeah, we talked about that.
That's mine too.
Contender.
That's
very good.
I feel like that's one of the only like popular like lesbian romance novels.
Okay.
It's like one of the only queer books I've ever read.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah. I know we've talked about the Song of Achilles as well. That's a big one.
It's really great. I'm looking at my other favorites. Last time I said They Both Die at the End. I think that still stands. It's a great book. But This Is How You Lose the Time War. It's my all-time favorite book. It's really short, but it's beautiful. It's poetic. It's literally time-traveling lesbians.
Oh my gosh.
And they're like on opposing the word. Sides of a war.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
And they like leave each other little love letters. Every time they like go to this new time, there's a love letter for each other, and they have to destroy it after because they
get
merch. But it is just it's so good. I don't know. It's beautiful.
That sounds really good, actually.
It's just anyway. Favorite book of all time.
I don't think I really have one outside of the other ones that we talked about, because unfortunately I have not read a book this semester.
Yeah, like I haven't read any new books. These are
busy
in
days.
The summer. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe we'll check some out.
I don't read. Actually, though, I did get the book about Lily.
Oh my god! So, yeah, me when I give you like, all the recommendations,
I'm illiterate.
I just take all of Lily's recs and I just go with them. So I did read. I didn't finish it, but I did read a bit of All About Love.
Yeah,
and I loved that.
I also have not finished. Yeah, yet,
I thought it was.
Fair.
I thought it was so inquisitive. And then I really want to read. This was Assal's recommendation. Aristotle and Dante.
That's what I meant. Yeah.
Because I wrote a story for my first draft class or writer's whatever class, and someone suggested, oh, this sounds like pretty similar to Aristotle and Dante, like discovered the secrets of the universe. So I really want to read it or at least watch the movie.
Yes.
If I can find it.
I also want to do that. Yeah. I've heard such great things about that one.
Yeah.
So
yeah. Mm-hmm.
I love the book. I feel like the book is slightly more nuanced just because. So this is not a spoiler, but the mom's a therapist.
Mm.
And that's such a big part of the story. But in the movie, it's kind of not mentioned as much. Mm. Like she's there. But I wish they brought her. They gave her a bit of more of a character. But otherwise, they did great.
Cool.
Yeah.
Well,
do we want to do queer TV show or TV character? Do you have a book?
Yellow Jackets!
My book?
Book did you have one?
I think it's just Evelyn again.
Okay, I think you said that. I think you said that.
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead. Favorite.
Yellow Jackets, I think currently I'm watching it right now. And it's so good.
It's incredible, right? I've made everybody in my life watch that show.
It's so good.
Like, literally. So you're not.
Watch it so I can talk about it. Anyway, I'm only two episodes in because I'm too busy. Mm-hmm. And I've been playing The Sims instead of watching shows.
Real.
But, you know, my Sim's still a lesbian, so.
I'm also in The Sims.
At Azure Porch and a little gay flag. Anyway.
I love making gay Sims. I also have a gay Sim couple going on right now. Yeah. They just went on a ski vacation. So, there you go.
What's funny is that I accidentally proposed to my girlfriend in Sims.
Oh, no.
And I was like, don't do it. I was trying to cancel it, but it already went through. So that I feel like that's the most lesbian thing. I accidentally proposed to my girlfriend too soon.
That is funny. My favorite show would probably be... Right now, also Yellow Jackets. Mm-hmm. But also, these are all like on Crave too. Honorable mention to The Last of Us, which I love the queer rap, and that show is so fantastic. Like, so fantastic. And also, A League of Their Own.
Yes.
I know I talked about that. I rewatched it again recently, and I was like, damn, like, this show really, really popped off. Mm-hmm. And there better be a second season, or I'm gonna actually sue everybody.
Yes.
But highly recommend all of those. If you're into more like fantasy, gore type of stuff, Last of Us and Yellow Jackets, mm-hmm. warning, yellow jackets. You gotta have a strong stomach for that one.
Yes, literally in the first 5 seconds, you're like, ah.
Yeah, you're like, I wanna throw up. but a more lighthearted queer one with some historical aspects, A League of Their Own, so good. So many cuties in that show, too. So, that's a good one. Yeah, I'm in love with all of them.
Yes.
I loved A League of Their Own. Oh my god, tongue tied. There were a lot of cuties in
there. There were.
Heartstopper.
Oh.
Heartstopper.
Very good. Very
that
fluffy.
One as well. We had a lot of queer ones we talked about on this show, actually. We talked about Heartbreak High as well. That had some.
About Young Royals.
Yes. Oh my
gosh. I was thinking about Heartbreak High for my pick.
That was a good one.
I really enjoyed the show. I don't know if I really enjoyed the representation that much. Like, I think I did. I just literally don't remember. It was
it was a decent quality, I think.
Yeah, it was like, okay. So I'm like, yeah.
Yeah.
But I think my TV show pick is Degrassi.
Ooh.
And I know that's so, like, broad because there's, like, 24 seasons. Yeah, a million generations. But I really like Degrassi. It's so campy. It's cheesy. Nothing makes sense. It's so over the top.
Yeah.
But still, I find the representation most of the time is pretty good. Like, it approaches things with, like, good emotional and moral, like, stories and explores, like, storylines that usually don't and are often, like, taboo. So, guys, watch Degrassi. It's a Toronto classic.
I think I watched the one. It was, like, it was on Netflix. It was younger. It was, like, a newer...
First class. Yes. Next gen. First class or something. One. Yes.
And I think I enjoyed it.
Yeah.
I think I watched it all. There was, like, some gay people in there, I think. That's why I watched it. Yeah.
Yeah, they have Miles, and he's, like, bisexual, and I like his character. He's really moody, and he's like, oh.
We love bi rep. We need more good bi rep presentation. Oh, my God. Anyway.
I don't watch a lot of TV. I'm sorry, I don't watch TV. I don't watch movies. I don't...
You don't read?
I don't read. What do I do? But, like, I think the last show that I can remember watching that had queer rep in it was actually, like, Big Mouth.
Oh, my God.
And, honestly, I can't comment on the representation because I don't remember it that well. I knew they explored asexuality, actually.
They do. Yeah. And...
Which I thought was so... interesting. I don't think I've ever seen that in shows before.
I've seen it in BoJack. But like
yes.
I feel like animated shows, like adult animated.
It's very rare. Yeah. It's like, very few.
You're right. Todd though in BoJack is also. Yeah. But yeah, there is some good representation in Big Mouth, I think.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like horribly offensive, but like at the same time it's like, you know.
Yeah. I like how Big Mouth portrays things in like a way that's easy to understand, like with their characters. Like I think they do a really good job of representing mental illness and anxiety and stuff like that. So in a really easy to understand way. So
and I like that, you know, sometimes when they make jokes you can tell the writer thinks it's a really offensive thing and they would never say it.
Mm.
But they say it because the character would.
Yeah.
And I don't know. I think that's always a nice touch when you can tell they're making fun of this person being offensive instead of just, you know,
being offensive.
Accidentally offensive.
Yeah, that's true. I really liked Jay's bisexual arc in that show. That was my favorite. I was like, I have to watch the next season to find out if they're in love. Cause
I just love Jay.
I know. I actually really love Jay, too. Jay is the best.
Yeah.
That's a good one, though. I think so. Yeah, good pick. Do we want to do movie? You mentioned movie. Also, Maddie's too busy to watch TV and movies and read because she's too busy carrying this show on her own. I thought of that when you were talking. I was like, I have to say it.
That's funny. Yeah, agree.
Anyway, queer movie or movie character as well, if you don't have a pick.
Aristotle and Dante discover the secrets of the universe. Yeah, it's so
that's good. A good one.
It's so fluffy. Favorite character? I don't know. All of a sudden, I don't remember any queer characters. It's like, I'm put on the spot. Anyway.
I think mine from this year would maybe have to be Tar, which was like one of the Oscar ones. It's not, she's not a good person, so it's not like, yay! But it's like, I don't know, it was the first time I saw, like, a, like, wealthy lesbian couple, like, they have a kid, like, they're very successful, and I was like, wow, and, like, Kate Blanchett was, like, wearing a suit, and I was like, wow, so.
Yay.
I didn't get the hype about Kate Blanchett before, like, she's playing all these lesbian movies, and I didn't get it, and then I watched this one, and she was wearing all these suits, and I was like, oh my god, I get it now.
She's so sleek.
She, like, wow, well-dressed.
Yeah.
Wait, is that the one about the... conductor?
Yes, the conductor.
Yes, you mentioned that one before. Okay, I should definitely watch that.
It's a little, like, sick and messed up, but it's actually a good movie. Like, it's really well, and, like, her performance in it is incredible, and she's super hot, okay. So. Definitely recommend. Sold. Yeah, definitely recommend that one. She's in Carol as well, which is the other lesbian one. Yeah. But there's too many historical lesbian ones. I'm like, sorry, guys. I just don't care. Oh, you know what I watched? This was a short film. It was with Bella Ramsey, who plays Ellie on The Last of Us.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, watch me forget the name now. But it was a lesbian, like, historical, like, witchy short film where, like, they're in love and then, you know, anyway. Yeah. I can't remember the name, so it's useless now that I'm bringing this up. But if you Google it, you'll find it. If anybody is interested in that.
That's funny.
Yeah, it was pretty good, though. I was like, wow, Bella Ramsey does a great job being gay. This is why we need gay people in gay roles, because I was like, I'm convinced that you're in love.
Right?
So, yeah.
Yeah. The gaydar. It starts ringing.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hmm. I think my favorite movie would have to be... well... my favorite movie from this year, it would have to be Shiva Baby.
Oh my god, I forgot about that one.
Yeah. I don't know. I just, like, I really enjoyed it as a movie and as, like, a queer movie, you know? Like, I'm like, yeah, I would watch this again. It was really cool. Yeah. And Danielle, relatable, panic attack queen, you know?
Yeah, I really liked that one. I feel like it's a nice, like, modern day representation, like a current, you know, it's very current and, like, very relevant right now.
I felt really seen as, like, a uni student, you know? But, guys, movie character, this is just me dreaming and manifesting, but now that Lady Gaga is Harley Quinn, and Lady Gaga in real life is bisexual, and Harley Quinn's bisexual.
That's exciting.
I'm just like, is it finally time we get a Poison Ivy on screen?
Yes. I just really want...
why is Lady Gaga's Harley Quinn so U-core? So...
honestly, she's great.
Stop.
Like, can't... why didn't no one think of this sooner?
Oh, no.
She's like, bye. She's perfect for the role.
Ugh, I love her.
I don't know. Maybe they did that on purpose.
And she, I feel like she matches Joaquin Phoenix's, like, level of, like, Joker.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Sort of, like,
I'm glad they went with someone, like, mature and not, like, a young Margot Robbie type.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Not that Lady Gaga's old. She's just, like... She's elegant and crazy.
Elevated.
Ah, I'm so excited for this movie. Sorry. Like, we went off topic. Joker is not a queer movie.
Yeah.
No.
Neither is the Barbie movie, but did you guys see the
Barbie movie? It's queer coded.
It is.
Everyone go to the theaters in pink, dress up.
I'm literally bought so
excited for it
last year.
I cannot wait.
Where's the gay Barbie?
Cannot wait. Anyway, Maddie, what's your favorite queer movie if you have one?
Okay, the only queer movie I watched this year.
Well, I know your answer again. You're gonna say My Policeman.
Yes. Yeah, it was My Policeman. I don't know if it was like my favorite queer representation. It was like.
It was kind of sweet.
It was sweet. It was my favorite movie in the world, though.
No.
I'll say that. But you know what? I love to see Harry Styles on screen, playing a queer character. So. Yeah.
Ooh. Yeah. Sorry, I keep getting an idea. a thought. But there's a new queer movie coming out. It's because it's similar, I guess, where Pedro Pascal and some other guy are playing, like, gay farmers or something. I think it's also a little bit historical. So, I don't know. Kind of similar.
The restraint I had to put in to not immediately say daddy. Anyway.
Well, you just said it, so.
I just thought it'd be funny to make fun of myself. You know what's funny? I wouldn't even, like, he's attractive, but not that way, but
I want him to be my god.
Everyone keeps saying it, so now my brain's like, ah, oh, yes.
I'm like, we're going there. I keep seeing things that are like, oh, The Last of Us is so good, I wish dads were real. And I'm like, yeah, like, come on.
Father figures.
Anyway. My policeman, sorry, did you want to say more about it? I kind of cut you
off. That's my review.
Okay, nice.
Amazing.
Not the best, but okay, I think. Yeah.
Yeah.
Nice. Gets the job done.
Gets the job done,
it's
for
sure.
It's a movie.
You know what?
It's a good movie.
I cried a little at the end, I think, when I watched it, when the ending was a little sad.
Yeah.
I think I shed a little tear. So there you
one
go.
Tier.
I honestly don't remember if it's like so long ago.
Okay.
What else? What can I remember?
Wait, are we asking about our next topic?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. We all just had a...
we do have one song break.
Oh, so let's do our song break.
I think before our song break, though, maybe we should go into our favorite episode. Or should we do the song break first?
I think we should do a song break first,
okay.
Maybe.
Okay, song break
and
first.
And then do our thing.
Cliffhanger.
So, the first song of the day. Who remembers when we had... our lovely guest.
Liam. Oh my gosh.
I remember.
Song. Yes. I'm so excited.
I remember.
Shout out Liam.
We love you, Liam. And Liam recently released Don't Call Me At a Party.
Yes!
Don't
Call Me
At a Party. So we need to play it right now. So here is Liam Bennion, Don't Call Me At a Party.
We're all going to dance right now.
Yeah.
Yeah. Don't Call Me At a Party.
I don't know what else you want me to tell you to force them to let you in.
Don't call me at a party, cause I don't wanna know how he's all over Molly and she's all in the coke. Oh baby, I'm so sorry, can see you through the smoke. I really gotta go, so don't call me at a party. They're playing shitty rap songs. Tell me how the hell you even sing along to this. It's been a minute too long. I'm sitting on the phone hearing all the thrills I've missed. Wish you would just speak up. I really wanna know about the best friend you just met. You're spilling words in your cup, but the night ain't over yet. Maybe just tonight I wanna party with the regulars. Get on some ice cause I don't deal with the temperature. Would've been so nice if you were hitting up a cellular. So keep on telling her. Don't call me at a party cause I don't wanna know how he's all over Molly and she's all in the coke. Oh baby I'm so sorry, can see you through the smoke. I really gotta go, so don't call me at a party cause I don't wanna know how he's all over Molly and she's all in the coke. Oh baby I'm so sorry, can see you through the smoke. I really gotta go, so don't call me at a party. Now how's it feel way up there? Tell me how you're breathing in a crowd with such thin air. Please excuse the
insight. And Glee is always a fun one to talk about.
Yes.
And Madie would joined us on that one. So
stop.
The whole gang was there.
Yeah.
Honestly, the Glee episodes, like both of them, were my favorite of all time. Mm-hmm. I just love Glee, and I think it was such a fun episode.
Yeah.
And it was such a fun discussion, and you can never go wrong with Glee. I just love Glee.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think, yeah, all-time favorite. I'd be the same. But I did really love when we interviewed Peter.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, true.
Literally, like, I wasn't even the one interviewing, but I was like, oh, my gosh, I've been listening to so music interesting. Forever. Anyway.
I think my fave episode from this season... Okay. Either this one... Or maybe the trans episode we had, because I really liked our discussion during
that.
Yeah,
that was a good one, actually.
Yeah.
I feel like we talked about a lot of good stuff.
We've had a lot of good episodes.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of good discussions. Yeah, Shiva Baby 2 was a fun one, I think.
I love Shiva Baby, obviously. Yeah. And I think my favorite episode of all time was either... I really liked our Euphoria one.
Ooh,
our
yes.
Glee one.
Yeah.
And then, personally... In season 1, episode 3, we had that random episode where we just talked about queer things.
I was just gonna say the My Little Pony episode.
My Little Pony episode.
No, the M-Preg episode.
Yeah, where we all just, like, talked about the creepiest.
That was a really random episode. I love
it. So random.
The random episodes always end up being fun, I think.
Yeah. Wait, guys, shout out Ray. For being with us during season 1.
Yes.
And season 2, I think. Yes.
Not
someone confirm.
No, not season. Oh, wait. Season 1 and season. All of last year, Ray was with
us. On Discord. Yeah.
Discord era times.
So, yeah. Shout out to Ray.
Shout out to Ray. And then Ray brought us Lily.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yay.
Lily.
Love to be here. So happy to be here.
Oh, yeah.
Love you all.
We're here for a season.
Yeah. I came the second season.
That feels weird because I feel like you're... Oh, you've always been here. No, it feels here.
Like... I know.
But I used to, like, watch it, I think. Yeah. Like, I used to... So I also kind of... I think I was on the last episode for some reason.
Yeah, you were.
Yeah.
You were a special guest.
Yeah, I was a special guest. That's funny. Yeah. Yeah.
You're meant to be here.
That does feel so long ago, though.
I know. It was.
Crazy. It was, yeah. That's crazy. Yeah. It's been a long road.
I think our most controversial episode was the queer baiting one. That was a rough episode.
It was like, honestly, like, we were like...
He didn't.
We were having a discussion. Like,
yeah, that was a big one.
That was different.
But you know what? I think it's also important for us to sometimes, like, engage in those discussions.
Yeah,
even where
I think
we
so
might
too.
Not agree.
It's,
we don't have to agree.
I think it just felt weird because usually we agree on stuff, mm-hmm. and I was like, oh, this is
for
this
sure.
a new experience.
For sure.
Yeah.
It definitely is good, I think.
Yeah.
Like, we have a lot of different perspectives, just every single one of us, you know, completely different. So I think it's really good, especially when we're talking about, like, queer topics and stuff, right? Because neither of us want to speak
like,
for, like,
queer
the whole
media
community.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, for sure. Did you say yours?
I said mine.
Okay, so do we want to...
We have some questions.
Yeah.
I posted on the Instagram, I was like, give us questions, guys, for the last episode. So, the first question. What is your favorite woman, loving woman relationship in any media? Books, TV, etc.
Oh my gosh.
That's really hard.
That's a crazy question.
Can I say the same thing as my favorite book?
Oh my god.
Yeah, go for it.
I mean, it's not really like accurate representation because I'm not even sure if they're real people because it's so far in the future. But I just love it. It's so cute. I feel like it's the epitome of... like what people think lesbian media is, which is just like time travelers, witchy, funky, I don't know. Not for now, unless I remember something else.
I love it.
That's a really hard one. I'm literally like Googling. Oh my god, you know what was a good one? I rewatched Orange is the New Black recently. Pusey and Soso.
How
was
dare
like...
you steal my answer, Lily?
Oh my god,
I'm
really?
Gonna come over there.
Sorry. That
no,
was
it's
really
okay.
Good one.
I know.
Pusey was like so important to me. Soso was a little annoying, but that's okay. But that was a really good one. I also am a really big fan of the one gay couple in Yellow Jackets. Minor spoiler, maybe. but I don't think so because it's whatever. But Thaisa and Van are like so adorable. And Van is like my favorite character in the show. So yes. Love that. But that's a really hard question. I feel like there's a lot. I feel like I would have such a different answer a couple years ago, too.
Answer Princess Bubblegum and Marceline.
Oh my god, that's a good one.
That's
a
really good one. And I'm like, oh my gosh, I forgot about them.
That's a good one. I remember watching like edits of them on YouTube in like grade 9.
I'm a sucker for like an opposites attract. Yeah. You know, like the tough dark one and then
the la la.
Me with my pink hair daydreaming, whatever.
Yeah, where's your Marceline?
I know. Guys, hit me up. Marceline's out there. I'm ready. I think my favorite WLW couple. Harley and Ivy, obviously, fits that dynamic once again.
Is that canon? Like, actually?
Yes. They are married.
Yeah. Oh, that's crazy. I didn't know because I don't really watch any of those.
I think it's in the comics.
It's in the comics mostly, and then in the animated TV show that's airing, and then, but, like, it's not really, the wedding is recent news, but, like, the relationship has been going on for a while, like, I think since the 2010s, but I like Harley and Ivy, Santana and Brittany, obviously.
Oh, yes, 100%. And
always and goal.
Always, yes. Yeah. That's probably one of the best ones of all time, to be honest.
I think so.
Yeah.
I think mine is, I don't even know their names, honestly, but the Bly Manor couple.
Oh, yes.
Poppins and whatever.
Throwback.
I don't remember the names, but I love that one. And then also, Casey and Izzy from Atypical.
Oh my god, I was just gonna say that. Yes, that's a really good one. Yeah. They were super cute, and that was some good, like, wholesome, like, high school.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Representation, you know. I feel like the L Word had a few good ones. Yes. The original L Word, Tina and Bette is like a pretty big favorite. But I just like Shane, to be honest. Yeah.
There's also the what's their name? The lesbian couple from Heartstoppers.
Mm-hmm. They're great. Yeah, I don't remember their name. They're not on it tons, but hopefully if we get another season, maybe.
I hope so.
Maybe there'll be some more of them.
And then we're gonna speed round because we actually have quite a few questions.
Oh my god.
We're gonna speed round, guys. Okay.
Oh my gosh.
What piece of queer media would you want to turn into a TV show / movie next?
Oh my god, these are all really good questions.
How do I, Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo.
The stress
that
of
is becoming a movie.
Yes,
they're
but
making
I want it to become a TV show.
Oh.
An episode for each.
What did you say?
Seven Husbands of Evelyn Hugo, but like a TV show.
Yeah, that's a really good one.
Because I feel like it'd be a great TV show.
I'm excited for that movie.
Yeah. I would do Lady Gaga doing a bisexual version of Harley, finally, on screen.
Yeah, that's a good one. Man, I have no idea.
Because
most of the queer things that are already a TV or movie that I watch.
Mm-hmm.
So
that's
a hard one, but...
Pass.
Maybe I just want more.
Yeah.
Maybe like more diverse beyond like gay, lesbian.
Yeah. Oh, you know what? I want Tom and Greg from Succession to finally be in love. I don't know if you guys have watched Succession.
I have no idea who those people are.
You all should be watching Succession.
Shout out Tom and Greg.
Shout out Tom and Greg. Faves. Anybody who's watched Succession knows what I'm talking about. So.
Yeah. Should we do next question?
All right. What is something you're each looking forward to for this summer?
Moving.
Money.
I want to go to California with my friends, so I'm really manifesting that. Yeah,
that's exciting.
Manifesting,
Vegas, so
saving.
Ooh, Vegas.
Yeah.
I'm not going anywhere, but I am moving out of my terrible apartment, hopefully into a better apartment.
That's like better than vacation.
I hope that will improve my life quality by 50%.
Love that for you. That's a huge percentage.
Yeah, well, you know, right now it's not too nice. So anyway,
Arctic Monkeys concert. Anyway,
there's that queer music festival too.
Oh yeah,
that's a good
festival.
That's an exciting thing.
yeah,
I'm excited to just not have school.
Yeah, I'm traveling a lot. I'm starting a new internship. So
oh my gosh,
it'll
that's
be
exciting.
A busy but a fun summer.
Yes.
Yes.
That is exciting.
Quickly. What are you wearing to the Terras?
Oh.
Only me and Kiyana are going to the Terras, yes. But...
I will be working capitalism. We love it.
Yeah. But we're showing up in a little black moment with...
Matchy, matchy. I want to have leather sock gloves.
Ooh.
I'm turning my... Leather, sorry, leopard.
Yeah.
The animal, but you know, not uh-huh. real fur. It's just, I have leopard socks. I'm gonna turn them into gloves. We'll see. I want to go for 2000 glamazon.
That's exciting.
But
TTC. I don't think I'm gonna be there. But if I was there, I would wear a very nice suit, dress yeah. shirt, tie moment.
Yeah.
Nice.
But I don't think I can go, unfortunately. Yeah. I also don't own any of those items, technically. I mean, I do have a tie and a shirt, but it's not the right vibe. Yeah. So,
well,
you know.
We'll be posting some pictures
yeah,
tonight.
Yeah, post some fit
and
pictures
we will,
for
we're
us.
We're going to Photoshop a salad. So.
Yeah.
Yeah. And then our last comment, rather, is this is the best Spirit Live show of all time.
Aww. Aww.
Yes.
So, our impact.
Say what you want about that.
Yeah. Thank you so much to whoever commented that.
Thank you to our fans.
Thank you to our fans. We love you all. Thank you so much for supporting us through the years. It's been a journey. It's been a good one. I think I'm gonna miss doing this a lot. I'm gonna miss you guys. I feel like we just get to hang out like every week and it's like fun.
And I want to thank you guys. Like, this was literally just an idea, and you guys helped bring it to reality.
And
I think that's really neat.
I think it was really fun. And, you know, we talked about so many different topics, and just, like, I don't know. I feel like we all got to bond a lot every week. So, Madie, you're actually going to make me cry. Like, don't look at me. Like, actually, don't look at me. Like, goodbye. I can't do it. Yeah, but hopefully we'll be seeing some... I actually can't look at you. Goodbye. Hopefully we have a little reunion at some point. This won't be the last you see of us, hopefully.
No.
Queerity Queer lives on.
We'll come back. Yeah.
I'm going to make us in The Sims and make us all hang out.
Oh my God. We can podcast. We can live show.
In The Sims.
Not on the stream.
Anyway.
With that, we loved each other too hard that we don't even have time for an outro song, so I apologize for that.
This is our outro. It's our goodbye.
We can sing a good...
Goodbye.
What's the song they sing in The Sound of Music before they all go to sleep or whatever?
What? We don't have time.
Okay. Unfortunately.
We love you guys.
Bye. Thank you so much for watching.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Sending us so much love to you all.